Thank you. Krishna Krishna Vabhadreshu
Nastaparesu Vabhadreshu
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke
Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtaki
Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtaki.
We're going through the prayers by Queen Kunti. So this is from the 10th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam. So today we're on text number
27.
I will read the Sanskrit.
我先来念一下梵文诗节。
Namo Kinchana Vitaya。
Namo Kinchana
Vritta Guna Vrittaye。Atma Ramaya Santaya。
Atma Ramaya Santaya。
Kaivalya Pataye Nama。
Kaivalya Pataye Nama。
Namo Kinchana Vitaya。Nivritta Gunavrittaye
Nivritta Gunavrittaye
Atma Ramaya Santaya
Atma Ramaya Santaya
Kaivalya Pataye Nama
Kaivalya Pataye Nama
Namo Kinchana Vitaya
Namo Kinchana Vitaya
Nivritta Gunavrittaye
Nivritta Gunavrittaye
Atma Ramaya Santaya
Atma Ramaya Santaya
Kauvaya Kauvau Kaivalya Pataye Namaha
Kaivalya Pataye Namaha
Namo Kinchana Vitaya
Namo Kinchana Vitaya
Nivritta Gunavrittaye
Nivritta Gunavrittaye
Atma Ramaya Santaya
Atma Ramaya Santaya
Kaivalya Pataye Nama
Kaivalya Pataye Nama
Namo Kinchana Vitaya
Namo Kinchana Vitaya
Nivritta Gunavrittaye
Nivritta Gunavrittaye
Atma Ramaya Santaya
Atma Ramaya Santaya
Kaivalya Pataye Namaha
Kaivalya Pataye Namaha
Anybody else like to chant?
Namo Kinchana Vitaya
Namo Kinchana Vitaya
Nivritta Gunavrittaye
Nivritta Gunavrittaye
Atma Ramaya Santaya
Atma Ramaya Santaya
Kaivalya Pataye Namaha
Kaivalya Pataye Namaha Yes? Chintamani Rada
Namo Kinchana Vitaya
Namo Kinchana Vitaya
Nivritta Gunavrittaye
Atma Ramaya Santaya
Atma Ramaya Santaya
Kaivalya Pataye Namaha
Kaivalya Pataye
Namaha
Namo Kinchana Vitaya
Namo Kinchana Vitaya
Nivritta Gunavrittaye
Nivritta Gunavrittaye
开口呀，开开呀嘛。
Nama Kinchana
Vitaya
Nama
Kinchana
Vitaya Nivrita
Kunavitaya Nivrita
Kunavitaya Padma Ramaya
Santaya
Padma
Ramaya Santaya
Kaivaya
Padaya Namaha Kaivaya Padaya Namaha。
小美丽金，
谢谢。
南无金刹那比他呀，
译文，我虔诚地顶拜您，物质上穷困潦倒之人的财富，您不介入物质自然属性相互间的作用与反作用，您自给自足，因而最和蔼可亲，是一元论者的主人。
Om Jnana Tamarandasya Gananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Pancha Kaupata Rubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Vayavacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo NamahaJai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasati Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama So Queen Kunti begins her prayer this evening by describing that Krishna is the property of those who have nothing material.
Kunti 皇后呢，在此她开始，就是向 Krishna 说到，就是。您是物质上穷困潦倒之人的财富。
But actually, we know in the material world, it's impossible to have nothing.
但是我们都知道，其实，在物质上，在这个生存中，要到达一无所有，其实是不可能的。
We all have something, right?
我们总是要有一些东西。
So.What happens though is we will give up something to get something better.
所以我们应该是这么说，是这么做，就是我们放下一些东西是为了得到更好的东西。
Just like young children, they like to play, they don't like to go to school and study.
比方说那个年轻的孩子啊，就是不喜欢上学。他喜欢玩，喜欢待在家。
But they know if they don't go and study, then they don't get better education.
但是他们知道，如果不上学的话，就没有的办法得到好一些的教育。
It affects their future in the world. If they don't study, then in the future they have no education. They will not be able to situate very well, to fix himself very nicely in the world.
如果没有上学受教育的话，那么就会对未来产生影响，他就没有办法在未来能够在社会上出人头地啊，得到一些好的待遇。
We even have a saying, of course, in Chinese, "Xiao Zhuan Bu Nu Li."
少
力，
少
力，
少
数
不努力，
少壮不
少
壮，少壮不努力，
老大徒伤悲。
老大怎么样？
徒伤悲。
哦，徒伤悲，徒伤悲，老大徒伤悲。
Means if Xiao Zhuan is the name of someone. You see, if he doesn't work hard when he's young.Then he will regret it later on.
少壮不努力，小时候如果不努力，就会懊悔不已。
And similarly, you know, somebody you may be working in a job, you have a job, you give up one job because you have a better job.
那么一个人，即便他得到了一份工作，他也可能因为找到了更好的工作。而放弃了原本的工作。
And the same way a devotee will give up the material world.
同样，奉献者，他选择，放下这个物质世界。
Not to do nothing.
放下物质世界并不是什么都不做。
But to do something more in the spiritual platform.
而是去做一些比较处在灵性层面上的活动。
Just like.When I joined the Krishna Consciousness Movement,
就像当年我加入了 Krishna 知觉意识运动。
You know, people say, why are you giving up your job? You know, why you want to go and just chant Hare Krishna?
人们也觉得大惑不解，你为什么要放弃你的工作，然后就去念诵，只是念诵圣名呢？
You have a job, you know, you should work in your.Keep your job.
你有工作，你应该好好维持你的工作啊。
I'm going for a better job.
但是我说我有更好的工作啊。
I'm going to work for Krishna.
我想要为 Krishna 工作，我得到了更好的工作。
So, we have the example also. There were some very nice devotees who were followers of Lord Chaitanya.
我们有一些很好的例子，就是一些主宰天涯马帕布的跟随者。
The Goswamis of Vrindavan.
这个 Vrindavan 的这六位 Goswami.
Rupa Goswami, Sanatan Goswami.
比方说像 Rupa Goswami, 还有 Sanatan Goswami.
They were two brothers.
他们是两兄弟。
And they were very important people. And they were working.For the a Mohammedan ruler, 500 years ago, there was this Mohammedan ruler, Nawab Hussein Shah. The Nawab. Nawab means like emperor.
那这两兄弟呢，他们其实都是位居高官哦。他们当时是在穆斯林的统领，就是他们的穆斯林的就是统治者的手下当官，那这个，所以他那个统领叫做 Nawab.
He was in history. He's a very big man.Famous man.
所以在历史上那个可真是个大人物。
If you come to India sometime, I hope you will come sometime to India. So there's a place which is not very far away from Mayapur. It's a place called Ramakeli.
那如果你们有机会来到印度，事实上应该去。有个地方叫Ramakeli, 它是离 Mayapur 不远的地方。
And Rupa and Sanatan Goswami, before they joined Lord Chaitanya, they were both living there in this place, Ramakeli.
在 Rupa Goswami 跟 Sanatan Goswami, 他们加入竹柴泰雅马哈帕布之前，他们就是在这个城市叫做 Ramakeli。
And they were working for this Mohammedan ruler. He was ruling the whole of Bengal.
那当时呢，这两兄弟呢，就是为这个穆斯林的首领就是在那边工作。那当时呢，穆斯林是统治着整个孟加拉地区。
So Rupa and Sanatan, one was the prime minister.And one was the chancellor of the exchequer.
That 他们两兄弟呢，一个是所谓的那个部长就是这个国王手下穆斯林的首长的手下的部长。那有一个是管财务的财政部长。
那个是总统。
总统。
他是总统。
他是
总统。Sanatan Goswami, 他是总统。
总统，刚好是最大的。Because, 是总统。
Yeah, ruling under the Mohammedan ruler.
The ruler 是总统。
He's the emperor. He was the emperor.
He is the emperor.
Yeah, Nawab.
对啊，所以他不是总统 ，Nawab 才是总统，是国王，对不对？
总理。
总理，他是那个下面的那个人，是总理，不是总统，对不对？不是总统，是算是他们有叫做总理吗？当时的年代，
Anyway, they lived there, Ramakeli. It's a very wonderful place, very beautiful place, very peaceful. Many cows, and green everywhere, trees. You know, not like Taichung.
Oh, 说当时 Ramakeli 真的是一个很美好的地方。他说到处都是母牛，而且都是充满的就是翠绿的树木还有清澈的溪流，到处都是很干净。
So Rupa and Sanatan, they were living there because the Nawab, he had his headquarters there.
那这个 Nawab 当时在那边有一个他们的总部在那里。
And they built huge places, you know, big palace and forts, and the ruins are still there. You can see the ruins. People come to see the ruins. They come from the West, they come from America to see all the ruins there from the time of the Nawab.
哇，那个当时 Nawab 在那里盖的那个豪华的那种建筑物啊，真的是非常壮观。到现在还有各地世界各地的西方人啊，到处来到这个 Ramakeli 这个地方来参观当时留下来穆斯林统治的时候留下来的像宫殿般的那样的这种房子房间。
So, these two brothers, Rupa and Sanatan, they were grown up men, you know, they were middle aged already, you know, and they were very well educated. They knew many languages.
当时的 Sanatan Goswami 跟 Rupa Goswami, 他们已经差不多是步入中年的时候了，他们都是受到非常良好的教育，就是位阶很高，然后很有教育背景。
And they were speaking Persian, the language of Persia, you know, and they were speaking Bengali, of course, and Sanskrit, and all, many different languages they could speak.
他们这两兄弟真的非常有学问，而且真的是博学多才，还会讲各种的语言呢，像他说波斯语，很多讲梵文，就是他们也都非常的精通。
So they were brahmanas, they were born in a very good family. Remember yesterday we spoke about four things which people in material life like?
而且他们是出生在婆罗门的家庭。大家可记得昨天 Maharaj 讲到的有四种就是在物质上很被看重的资产是什么？富裕，很被看重的四种富裕。
美丽。
财富
wealth
and beauty
and
education education.
还有一个
yeah, high parentage.
Yes, right. The good family, right?
对，来自于出身很好的家庭。
So Rupa and Sanatan, they had the education, very good education, and they had also this good family, born a very good family.
嗯，那 Rupa 和 Sanatan Goswami 他们呢，真的是拥有所有的这些非常好的条件呢。他们出生在很好的家庭，然后很就是家里就是也是很富裕，然后拥有受了很高的教育，出身很高的门第。
And they had money, so a lot of money because they're working for the emperor.
嗯，因为他们是直接为国王工作，所以他们真的是挣了很多钱。
The emperor, he'd go out with the army, they'd go out and fight other kings and.Defeat all the other kings and take all their wealth, bring it back.
穆斯林总统，就是穆斯林的这些国王，他们真的打仗的时候，他们就打败了对方，把对方的钱财都掠夺过来了。所以其实他们是非常有钱。
But what happened was, they were working for the Mohammedan, and the Mohammedans were cow killers.
可是很可怕的是，这两兄弟呀。他们出生在婆罗门家庭，可是他们却为穆斯林的这个首领工作。那穆斯林是什么样的人呢？他们是会杀母牛的，他们的习惯杀母牛。
So Rupa and Sanatan, these two men, they had been given Muslim names. One was called Dabir Qas, and the other was called Sakar Malik.Dabir Qas, Sakar Malik. The Muslim names.
真的，他们就放弃了他们的穆斯林的名字，这两兄弟。
And they become like Muslim. They were dressing like the Muslim. They didn't grow the beard, you know. The Muslim, they won't shave, you know. They grow the beard.
Oh, you mean? Maybe I say the wrong thing. They got them the Muslim name.Right? Oh, they give up.
No. They were working for the Muslim.
Yeah, so they
called
them.
So the Muslim honored them.
Honored them.
Gave them Muslim names.
对，我刚刚讲错了。他是说，因为他们为穆斯林工作，所以这个穆斯林就要给他们荣誉，给了他们这两个名字来表彰表扬他们这样子。
But actually in their heart, they're devotees of Krishna.
但是这两兄弟始终在他们的心中，他们都一直是 Krishna 的奉献者。
And they were making Ramakali, they were making it into another Vrindavan.
他们简直把这个地方 Ramakali 变成了 Vrindavan, 另一个 Vrindavan.
So, they wrote to Lord Chaitanya. Lord Chaitanya had taken Sanya.Well, Lord Chaitanya was very famous as a young man. He had, you know, when he was a young teenage man, he defeated Keshava Kashmiri, the pundit.
Keshava Kashmiri, yeah. 他当年呢，主产天涯马哈帕布啊，他还在就是青少年的时候，他就打败了Keshava, Kashmiri, 他就这个大学者就打败了他。
And at that time, Lord Chaitanya was only 16 years old.
当时他打败这个大学者的时候，他也只不过是16岁大。
He had opened his own school and he was teaching.
他自己开设的学校，自己教书，16岁哦。
And he became famous as a teacher.
然后他就这样子，就是变得非常的有名，成为一个很有名的老师。
But then he gone to Gaya and he got initiation from Lord Chaitanya. He got initiation. Lord Chaitanya went to Gaya, Buddha Gaya, that place of Gaya, where Buddha is famous. There's a place there where people go to worship the lotus feet of Vishnu in Gaya. So Lord Chaitanya went there to do the ceremony for his father. His father had died.
朱彩台亚麻布的父亲离开身体之后呢，他就去到了嘎雅这个地方。那在嘎雅这个地方，就是那里有一个就是 Vishnu 的那个很大的神像。那
不是神像，
是
一个脚印。
哦，对对，是 Vishnu 的脚印，对，是 Vishnu 的脚印。然后他想要去那边为他的父亲做一些仪式。
At that time, he got initiation.
他就在那个时候得到了启迪。
Ishvara Puri.
他得到了 Ishvara Puri 的启迪。
And so when he came back to Mayapur, then what happened was the Chankazi had broken the madanga. He said, "No more kirtan."
然后当时后来朱彩坦亚马哈帕布回到玛雅普之后，正好发生这个 Chankazi 把他们这个 Sankirtan 大军的那个 Miranga 把它打破了，这个很严重的事件。
The Muslims, they don't like.
穆斯林他们真的不喜欢 Kirtan.
So they came to Srivastava's house because Lord Chaitanya was having Kirtan every night. They were not sleeping.
因为当时的朱彩坦亚马哈帕布他们呢、每天根本都不睡觉，都在 Srivas Pandit 家，都一直在 Kirtan。 穆斯林就是不喜欢。
Lord Chaitanya said, "Why should we sleep every night? We waste so much time sleeping. We will just have Kirtan all night."
朱彩坦亚马哈帕布就说，为什么要睡觉？我们浪费了那么多时间睡觉，我们每天晚上都要继续的 Kirtan。
Just like Ojaspi was reminding me one time in the Philippines with Tamal Krishna Goswami. It was Ekadasi, and Tamal Krishna Goswami said, "Today we will all fast, and tonight we will not sleep. We will have kirtan all night."
Ojaspi 他分享了有一次在菲律宾啊，然后那个当时 Tamal Krishna Goswami 在。他就当遇到了一个 Ekadasi， 然后他就跟大家宣布，今天是 Ekadasi， 我们全部的人都一起来断食，然后晚上的时候我们不睡觉，我们都来 Kirtan。 我们晚上不睡觉 Kirtan 就被邻居赶出去了。
we only did it one time. 我们就做一次，
做一次，做一次。
太累了，
太累了，断食又 kirtan 整夜的通宵 kirtan。
But some people do that every Ekadasi.
但是有人每隔就是每到了 Ekadasi 都这么做。
There was another sannyasi who came here to Taiwan. Ojaspi was reminded. The one sannyasi Madhava Ma.Anyway, one sannyasi is an American body, and he will stay awake every night on the Kalasi. On the Kalasi, on the Kalasi.
On
the Kalasi.
Doesn't
sleep.
Chan? Chan, 64. 对，有一个美国的sannyasi 啊，气绝阶层的，就是灵性导师，他每到了 Kalasi， 他都是有这样的誓言，就是晚上他都是不睡觉。那个晚上他整夜都不睡，都在念诵这样。
So Rupa and Sanatan, they were big men. They had a lot of money, and they had a lot of fame and power. But they gave it all up to go to join Lord Chaitanya.
所以当时的 Rupa 跟 Sanatan Goswami, 他们是赫赫有名的当时的大人物，他们非常的家财万贯。然后，而且又那么有名望、有势力、有力量，但是他们毅然而然加入了朱彩坦亚马哈帕布的行列。
They went to live in Vrindavan.
他们去到了 Vrindavan， 住在那里。
To sleep under a different tree every night.
每天晚上都睡在树下。
Make a different tree every night.
而且不只是在树睡在树下。而且每天晚上还要换一棵树。
Don't want to get attached.
这个意思就是说，不要对任何事情发生执着，不要连对树都发生执着，所以每天都会换。
So they were living like that very simply.
所以他们真的是过上一种非常简朴的生活。
And they wrote books about Krishna and about Bhakti Yoga.
嗯，然后他们也撰写书籍，写有关于 Krishna， 还有关于奉爱的啊、哦、这个书籍。
500 years ago, there was no laptop, there was no Apple.
500年前没有苹果电脑。
There,
哦，就是。
They wrote on the palm leaf.
他们。不是这么简单的啊，啊，没有笔记型电脑，他们是直接写在这个哦棕榈叶上啊，这个树叶上。
But they wrote books which are a treasure. They're very valuable books.
但是他们在树叶上写下的啊，这些所有的这些文献呢，可是真的是价值非凡，就是他们亲笔写的。
So they gave up.So much position and wealth for the service of Krishna.
所以他们为了 Krishna 放弃了所有的一切的财富，还有他们的地位。
They thought, why should we serve these meat eaters, cow killers?
嗯，他们就想，我们为什么要去为那些什么就杀母牛、吃肉的人工作？为什么要去帮他们呢
？So they. When they retired, they had so much money, it could fill a boat.
他们有钱到什么程度？就是他们退休的时候啊，他们的财富啊，就是整大艘船都在够。
So he divided the money. He gave half of the money for the service of the temples and the brahmanas.
他们把一半的钱啊留作给庙宇啊。就是 the temple and oh, Brahmana, 还有 Brahmana.
And then 25% he gave for family.
还有25%的钱他留给了家人。
And he kept 25% for emergency.
那另外最后剩下的25%是留作紧急备用金。
And he gave that up, that is some house.
然后他很快的就分配好了，就放下所有的一切了。
So they gave up what it seems like, you know, we would like to get so much money, we would like to get so much big name position, but they gave all that up to go and live in the forests of Vrindavan.
他们很快的就下决断，就立刻不如气绝，他们就直接到了 Vrindavan 的森林去过日子，他们放下了他们的这种万贯的家财。哦、他们放下了他们的这样的享负盛名的这种地位，毅然决然的就离开了。
And they built big temples.
他们在那里还盖了大庙。
They went there with no money.
而且他们去的时候，其实他们根本就没有钱。
But Krishna sent people with money to help them to build big temples.
所以他们是真的是他自己都没有给自己什么，就是去到了那个地方，可是。却吸引了那些大人物来捐款，帮助他们盖庙。
Very big, beautiful temple.
那里他们盖了非常宏伟的大庙，很美的庙。
So Rupa and Sanatan, they lived there, and then there was another person called Raguna, who was also from a very, very rich family.
那六位 Goswami 中还有一个叫 Raguna，Das Goswami， 那他呢也是出生于非常显赫富有的家庭。
So he was a young man, and he got very attracted to Lord Chaitanya's movement.
他当时还很年轻的时候，他就非常的受到主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的运动的吸引。
And his father and his uncle were very rich men. They were supporting all of the brahmanas. They were giving charity to support all the brahmanas.
他的爸爸还有他的叔叔啊，他们啊还是伯父，不晓得，就是他们非常的有钱，到那些所有的婆罗门，他们都有办法源源不绝的供应他们财富来支持这些婆罗门。
But Raghunath wanted to go to join Lord Chaitanya.
但是 Raghunath 他一心想着是我怎么样才能够加入主 Chaitanya 呢
So sometimes he'd run away from home, and his father would send men to catch him and bring him back.
有时候他会逃跑，他会逃跑，逃跑之后，他爸爸赶快想办法找人家去把他带回来。
So then he thought, we'll get him a nice wife.
然后他们就想办法，哦，他说，这下子怎么办呢？于是就是帮他安排了一桩婚姻，让他娶一个老婆。
So they got him a very beautiful, sweet little girl, young woman, who would be a nice wife.
结果他们就想说，哇，给他娶一个美娇娘吧。果然就是一个非常年少，啊，非常美丽甜美的姑娘，啊，就让他结婚了。
But Raghunath was not very interested.
但是 Raghunath 一点都不感兴趣。
And his family thought what to do, maybe we should tie him up.
那他的家人就父母就觉得很非常非常的焦虑，很担心到底怎么办呢？也许我们已经无计可施了，那是不是就把他绑起来？
But they said he has a wife who is as beautiful as the goddess of fortune Lakshmi, and he has money like Kuvera, the treasurer of the demigods. These things cannot satisfy him. How will ropes ever control
him? 他们就想说，哇，我这孩子啊，他简直有这个家财万贯，有这么多的财富，像就是天堂的那个 Kuvera 啊，管财富的啊，半神人，他都他连这个，他有这么多。哦，这么多的财富，他都不觊觎了，哦，都不执着了。他有像这样的娇妻，像就是幸运女神那么美丽的妻子，他都不在意了。那绳子又怎么能捆绑得了他呢
？So it happened one time, Lord Chaitanya came to the area where Raghunath lived. So Raghunath went to see Lord Chaitanya, and he asked Lord Chaitanya.Said, I want to join and come and stay with you in Jagannath Puri.
Chaitanya told him.
Raghunath asked.
Na 有一次呢，就是主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就到来，他就见到了主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu， 那他就问说，我可不可以跟你去 Jagannath Puri 那边住
？Lord Chaitanya knew.He was the son of two very big rich men.
主舍天雅当时知道了，这个人 Raghunath 他是两个超级巨富的儿子。
So Lord Chaitanya told him, "Go home and behave like a normal person."
主舍天雅给他的训示是：你回家，过正常人的生活。
Don't be a foolish person.
不要当傻瓜。
Keep Krishna in your heart.
把 Krishna 放在你的心中。
And in the future, in course of time, Krishna will arrange for you.
时候一到， Krishna 自然会为你做出安排。
So Raghunath went home, and he behaved like a good person.
所以他就听话，他回家，他果然他表现的就像是一个好孩子。
And the parents were happy. Everybody was thinking Raghunath is okay now. He's very good.
父母就非常的满意，你知道吗？就说哎呀，我的 Raghunath 现在变乖了。
But then after some time, Lord Nityananda came.
但是不久之后，这个 Nityananda 来了。
To a place is called Panihati.
有个地方叫做 Panihati.
When we will go to India, we will go to Calcutta, and this place is not far from Calcutta, very near.
那这个地方呢，离加尔各答不远。我们去印度的话，有时候会抵达那个加尔各答。那是离这个Panihati 这个地方不远。
So.Raghunath went to meet Lord Nityananda there.
那这个 Raghunath 就是到了这个 Panihati 这个地方去见这个 Nityananda.
Now Lord Chaitanya, he is Krishna.
那主 Chaitanya 他就是 Krishna。
And who is Lord Nityananda?
谁是 Nityananda 呢？
Balaram.
是的，是 Balaram.
Krishna's big brother.
Krishna 的哥哥 Balaram.
哎，
对。
So Lord Nityananda, Rajendra Nandana se Sachi Sutta Hailahe Balaram Hailo Nitai. Right, there's Nitya Lord Chaitanya, Sachi Sutta, the son of Sachi Chaitanya, and Balaram Hailo Nitai. Nityananda was called Nitai.
所以 Maharaj 刚刚念的那段诗文是在讲说主 Chaitanya 他是 Sachi、
Sachi Sutta
Sachi Sutta
Son of Sachi
就是 Sachi 的儿子、Sachi Sutta 那这个 Nityananda、他是 Balaram 那他就是那个 Nitai、
So Raghunath came thereAnd Lord Nityananda saw, oh, Raghunath has come. He is the son of those two very rich men. And he's come here. And so he said, Raghunath, come here. Today I'm going to punish you.
结果 Nityananda 跑步就看到那个 Raghunath 来到了这个地方，对不对？他说，哎，大家知道吗？他是那两个巨富的。他是那个巨富的儿子啊，就是 Raghunath 你过来，好，我今天要好好的处罚你一下。
Punishment is you have to put on a feast for all the devotees、
他说我给你的处罚就是你要给所有的奉献者，你要给他们盛宴款待这样。
So if you go to India, this place Bengal, it's you knowPanihati is on the bank of the Ganga. It's a little village. You know, 500 years ago, there's no 超市,
没有超市,
没有超市时常买东西,
超市, 超
市,
超市,
超市, 超市, 那你知道吗, 那是一个小镇, 那是一个小镇, 它就是在靠近恒河岸边的一个小地方。啊，当时呢根本就没有超市 supermarket 超市，对。
So you have to buy what's available in the market. So in the summer it's very hot that time, not much growing, just some bananas and mango and yogurt. That's one night.
当时没有超市，所以只能在市场买东西。他们就看市场有什么呢？有香蕉，有芒果，还有酸奶。
And also rice.
还有米饭。
Bengali people have to eat rice.
就是孟加拉人。他刚刚讲那个地方其实在孟加拉的一个小镇。那孟加拉人呢，他们超爱米饭的。
In China, 他们说北方人吃面，南方人吃饭。
北方吃面，南方吃饭。这是中国是这样子，对不对？北方面食，然后南方吃饭。
So India is a bit like that also.
在印度也很像这样。
India, 北方人吃 chapati.
北方人吃 chapati, 那我也想去北方。
南方人吃饭。
南方人吃饭。
So Bengali people, they have this special rice. They call it flat rice. It's crushed rice, you know. And you just wash it in water, and you can eat it and digest.
Directly. Just put in the water, soak in the water, eat directly. 那在这个孟加拉有一种米饭呢。它是其实是被碾碎的，我们就叫碎米，知道吗？然后他们说那种米啊，它很容易消化，就是说你只要泡在水里，你就可以直接吃了，是这么简单的一种东西。
So there was a lot of he bought all the flat rice and they washed it in the Ganga. And they were right at the side of the Ganga, and they washed it in the Ganga water, and they got all the lots of bananas, always bananas, many bananas there, and the flat rice and the yogurt, and they got some condensed milk, and they mixed it all together, and they distributed that.
So this 盛宴是怎么样？他们买了。很多的香蕉、哦、然后他们把那个还有这个碎米嘛，碎米就是因为恒河就在旁边，他们就在恒河把那个米给泡这个，就 wash in the Ganga， 就是恒河把这个米给洗干净，然后他们又用了那个炼乳、哦、炼乳，然后还有酸奶、哦、就弄在一起、哦、把它做成了酸奶饭，是不是？
Yeah, it's a...They say Shira Dahi. Dahi means 酸奶。
酸奶 Shira Gati.
Shira is the flat rice.
Shira 是就是碎米。
Flat rice.
碎米。
And so they had a big feast for everyone. They offered it to Krishna first and they distributed to everyone.
所以他们就把这个这个食物先供奉给 Krishna， 然后就派发给所有的奉献者。
When you have a prasadam program, when you distribute prasadam in India, so many people come. You don't know where they come from. You know?
可是在印度就是这样，你只要有要派发prasadam的时候，突然知道吗？就所有的人都涌来，你真的不知道他们从哪里来，他们怎么会知道？就很多人都涌进来了。
And then everybody knew Raghunath's having a feast for everyone.
这消息怎么传开来了？大家都在讲说 Raghuna 他要宴请，知道吗？就是有这办这个盛宴啊，请奉献者吃饭。
And the vendors also came to sell. People came selling stuff.
很多的那个摊贩呢、啊，他们也都纷纷到来啊，因为人很多的地方就可以卖东西。
So Raghuna would buy everything.
然后这些市集啊、菜贩啊什么的，他们来 Raghuna。什么谁来都把它买下来，把那些东西买下来。
Distributed and fed everyone.
然后把所有的这些蔬果都派发给就是大家。
Even the dogs were fed.
连狗也被喂饱了。
So, Raghun, Lord Nityananda was very happy with Raghuna.
然后主尼亚南达就非常的满意，他对 Raghuna 很满意。
And so Raghunath came to him and said, "Please bless me, help me to get out of this material life."
然后好让他满意了，然后 Raghunath 就走向他，就跟他讲说，我请求你帮助我脱离这个世界，这个物质世界，你帮助我吧。
So Lord Nityananda said, "Yes, very soon you will get free."
然后这个 Nityananda 就告诉他。如你所愿，很快你的梦想就会成真了。
So Raghunath was happy. He pleased Lord Nityananda. He got the blessings from Lord Nityananda.
所以他真的很开心 ，Raghunath 很开心，他得到了主 Nityananda 亲自的祝福，他非常高兴。
And he went home.
他就回家了。
And he waited for the right time.
他就在等待这个时机的到来。
And it happened.After some time, he got the opportunity. He got away from home.
所以不久之后，他就逮到了一个很恰当的时机，他就离开家了。
And he went to Jagannath Puri.
他就到了 Jagannath Puri.
He stayed with Lord Chaitanya. He stayed there.
他在那里跟主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在一起。
But then, after some time, Lord Chaitanya disappeared.
但是不久之后。主柴太亚马哈帕布就消失了。
So then Raghunath went to Vrindavan.
隐居了。然后后来 Raghunath 就到了 Vrindavan.
And Raghunath lived in Vrindavan with Rupa and Sanatana.
然后 Raghunath 呢就到Vrindavan 跟Sanatana 跟 Rupa Goswami 在一起。
And he lived very simply, very austere.
他过着一种非常简朴、非常刻苦的、生活。
And he went to live at Radhakund.
他住在 Radhakund 那里。
And he wanted to develop the Radhakund. He wanted to make a nice place there.
他想要建设 Radhakund, 昆是虎的意思。
Nobody knew where is Radha Kund.
Nobody what?
Nobody knew.没有人知道 Radha Kund 在什么地方。Radha Kund 是 Radha Rani 沐浴的地方。
我失业了。
你让我失业。我没有工作了。
So, Raghunath went to live at Radha Kund.
So, Raghunath, he 就去住在那个 Radha Kund 那里。
Radha Kund is the place where Radharani will bathe.
你刚才说过了。Radha Kund 是 Radharani 沐浴的地方。他再重新给我工作，故意再讲一次。
Nobody knew where this place was. Lord Chaitanya came to Vrindavan and he was asking,Where is Radha Kund?
没有人知道 Radha Kund 在哪，在哪里呀？就主柴太呀，到了那里，他就说 Radha Kund 在哪里？有谁知道 Radha Kund 在哪里
？Nobody knew.
没有人知道。
There's a festival this month.
那个月。
The appearance of Radha Kund. Every year they have at this time in the month of Kartik.There's the festival, the appearance of Radha Kund.
每次到了这个达摩达尔月呢，都会庆祝这个 Radha Kund 显现的节庆。
Many people.
很多人在那里真的很热闹。
So anyway, Lord Chaitanya asked them about this place. What is the name of this village? And he said, "Oh, this is Aristadram."Is a place where Lord Krishna had killed the Aristasura demon.
Aristakram. 那就是那个地方叫 Aristakram. 那个地方因为 Krishna 是在那里杀死的这个牛魔 Arista 的地方。
And Lord Chaitanya then saw there's the rice field nearby, and he said, "This is the Radha Kund."
那结果主宰太阳就在这个。附近啊，看到有一挖这个那个稻田啊，他就说这个地方就是 Radha Kund 的所在地。
And Lord Chaitanya went into the rice field, and he took his bath there.
那个是一个小小的一个稻田，结果主宰太阳妈妈他不竟然认出那里就是 Radha Kund， 他就跳下去在那里沐浴。
And people were surprised. What? Why are you taking bath here?He told them that this is Radha Kund.
人们都很惊讶，你为什么在这里沐浴啊？他就跟人们讲说，这里就是 Radha Kund.
Very sacred place.
非常的神圣的地方。
So Raghunath came to live there, and he wants to make it a nice bathing ghat for people.
所以 Raghunath 他就是到了那个地方 Radha Kund 那里，他就在那个地方整建。把那个地方建设为一个很好的一个地方圣地。
Now Raghunath had left all the money. He didn't bring any money with him to Vrindavan.
那 Raghunath 尽管他是出生于那么有钱的家庭，但是他离家的时候一毛钱都没有带，身无分文。
Come to Vrindavan with no money.
他到 Vrindavan 的时候他是身无分文的。
So Lord Krishna arranged this one man.He was planning to go up to the Himalayas, to Badarik Ashram, and he wanted to give a big charity there, give a lot of gold as a donation.
那有一个人呢，刚好就来到那里。那个人他本来是要去喜马拉雅山的一个Badarik Ashram.
Badarik
Ashram. 他想要去那里，他想要把钱捐给那个地方庙吗？是庙吗？庙。但是后来呢，他就没有这么做。
On the way there, he had a dream, and in the dream, Krishna told him, "Don't take the money to Badarik Ashram. I want you to go to Vrindavan, go to Radha Kund, give the money to Raghunath."
结果这个人呢，这个有钱人呢，他就在路上啊，结果他就做了一个梦，梦到 Krishna， Krishna 就跟他讲说，你不要去了，你不要去那个 Badarik 那个地方。这个 Ashram 就是那个灵修所，你不要去那里， 你应该到了这个 Radhakund 这个地方，把钱这个捐给 Raghunath。
And so Raghunath got the money and he made the beautiful Radhakund and Shyamakund。
所以这个就是 Raghunath 他为什么会有得到这些钱哈，然后来建设这个 Radhakund 还有 Shyamakund， 就是这样来的。
So Krishna provides, he takes care.
所以我们要知道，从这些故事我们可以了解 ，Krishna 他提供所有的一切，他照顾所有的一切。
Just like Srila Prabhupada，
就像 Srila Prabhupada 也是这样。
He gave up everything.
他放弃所有的一切。
He had a family and he had children.
他有家庭，有小孩。
But as he got older, he understood.That there was not so much appreciation for him in the home.
但是他渐渐的年岁越来越大之后，他知道其实他在家里，其实他们并不会去珍惜这些东西。他觉得不想再继续这样。
So Srila Prabhupada understood it was time for him to leave the home.
所以他已经有感受到那种气息了，时间已经到了，所以他就决定要离开家里。
So he gave up one home with a few children.
所以他就他跟带着一个孩子离开家里。
He gave up his one house.
他放弃了一个房子。
And his family.
还有他的家庭。
And he went to Vrindavan.
他去了 Vrindavan.
And then later on went to America.
后来他又到了美国。
And Krishna gave him many children.
对，可是 Krishna 却给了他那么多那么多的孩子到美国之后。
And he gave him homes all over the world.
而且 Krishna 还给了他整个世界的家，他放弃了一个家 ，Krishna 给了他回应给他一整个世界的家。
And the children he got were they loved him much more than his own children.
对，虽然他放弃了家庭儿女，可是他后来在美国得到了那么多的。孩子对不对？跟随着就是他的孩子，爱他胜过于他自己的亲生孩子爱对他的爱很多很多。
So Krishna took away a few children and one house in the beginning.
所以 Krishna 刚开始的时候拿走了他的家、房子还有家庭、孩子。
But Krishna gave him much more.
可是 Krishna 回应给他的是更多、更多、更大的家。更多的孩子。
Anyone gives up something for the service of Krishna, they're not the loser.
所以当我们为了服务 Krishna 而我们牺牲放弃了一些东西，并不代表我们是输家，并不代表我们失去了什么。
So we should understand that if we sacrifice, if we give up our material life.For spiritual benefit, we can gain the greatest gift.
所以如果我们为了这个灵性生活为了 Krishna 而放弃了我们所谓的物质的生活的话，我们要了解一件事情，其实我们并不是失去什么，我们是获得更大更大的利益。
But if you just simply only material life, it will all be finished very soon.
可是如果我们只是聚焦于物质的生存，眼睛都只有看着、专注着要顾自己的物质生存的话，那意味着什么？那么我们这一生就白忙了。
You have nothing to show. You have nothing.
就真的是一无所有，知道吗？如果我们只是聚焦在物质上，我们最后是白忙一场空，真的是一无所有，那就是真的，那个结果是这样。
We leave the whole material life behind.
对，所以我们把物质的这种生存啊，物质的尘世的这些抛诸脑后。
When we are born in the world, we are born empty-handed.
我们不是就是赤条条的来吗？两手空空的来。
And when we leave the world, we leave it.
我们也是两手空空的走，不是吗？我们的生存是这么一回事。 我们不带什么来，可是我们走的时候也带不走任何东西。
Your nice apartment, your nice car, your bank balance, leave it all.
当时候一到，无论我们有什么名车豪宅，你的银行的存款簿有多大的数字，全部都要放下，全部都是别人的，都要抛诸脑后。
But if you've got some Krishna consciousness, if you've developed your consciousness of Krishna, then that will give you the better life.
可是如果我们真心的来好好的培养 Krishna 意识知觉的话，我们能够获得的是全新更好的生命处境，我们得到的是更好的。
Okay, any questions?
到目前为止，大家有没有什么问题？
你 got anything there?
你们有什么问题吗？大家可以先发问。秀有问题。
从 Maharaj 的结论，我想请问一下啊。当初您的放弃您所有的，然后您现在真的获得更多。
不用翻译。
要翻译一下。
Okay, she says she wants to listen from you, your own experience. So at that time, in the beginning, you give up everything, and you know, just practice Krishna consciousness. And so she would like to know if you really feel better, you get a better life.
Oh yeah.
是的，毫无疑问的，我一定是得到了更好的生活。
Every day I think about how fortunate I am. Every day I think I'm so fortunate.
我每天都是这样的，这个我的心都是觉得非常的感恩。我怎么会如此的幸运到这样？每一天都觉得自己。怎么会如此的幸运？
Where would I be in the material world?
如果不是这样的话，我现在会在物质存在的哪里、什么地方流浪飘荡呢？流落到何方呢？
You know, I think about the other people, like the people I studied at college with. What is their situation now? What are they doing?And what am I doing?
他就想到说，他当时的同学啊，在大学一起念书的人啊，他们现在都在哪里？他们在做什么？ Yeah. 对不对？那种比较，就知道说，哦，自己真的太幸运了。
What are they doing? They're all retired.
他们都退休了嘛。
They're doing. They're bored. They have nothing to do. They don't know what to do.They're bored. 他们觉得生活无聊。
They feel bored. Okay, 他们觉得太无聊了。他们的生活退休之后真的很无趣。
They have no future in the. They have seen nothing.
他们觉得自己没有什么未来，看不到什么希望。
Life has no more meaning.
他觉得生活这样下去到底有什么意义呀？
But I'm fully busy. We're opening new temples in different places.
可是我却不一样，我却无时不刻都很忙。我到世界各地各个庙宇，到处去照顾这些奉献者们。我就是不一样的生活。
Taking devotees to visit holy places.
带着奉献者去朝圣。
And having groups of people come from China to Rathiatras in Malaysia and Thailand.
那马尔杰带着来自中国啊，中国大陆还有 Malaysia 马来西亚啊，泰国的奉献者们去朝圣。没有台湾了。
哎，中国人不可以进来台湾，他们不允许中国人进来台湾。不那么容易。
我是说带他们去，带去朝圣。
可以在台湾演出小生，欢迎你们来，
欢迎欢迎，
当然可以。
Thank you, Maharaj. Please accept my humble obeisances. As mentioned, Ramakali is the tree which the huge statue of Lord Chaitanya stands Tamo tree. You understand this question?
Which question? As mentioned, Ramakali is the tree where the huge statue of Lord Chaitanya stands.
他想知道 Ramakali 那个地方那棵巨大的树啊，啊，就是有这个主宰太阳马哈布的雕像，哈、啊，那他的雕像所伫立的那棵树是不是就是塔摩树
？Yes, there's a Tamo tree. Tamal trees, you know, they're dark colored trees. You get a lot of tamal trees.、
Mm.
So there's a tamal tree there in Ramakali. And Lord Chaitanya came there to Ramakali. He visited Rupa and Sanatana.、Mm.
对，那个塔茂树它是颜色就是比较黑的那个颜色。然后Maharaj 说，主宰太阳 Mahaprabhu 就是来到这个 Ramakali 这个地方。会见了 Sanatan Goswami 和 Rupa Goswami.
When Radharani will feel separation from Krishna, she will embrace the Tamal tree.
当 Radharani 真的非常思念 Krishna 的时候，她就会抱着这个塔茂树 Tamal.
Because the Tamal tree is the color of Lord Krishna.
因为塔茂树 Tamal tree 呢，它就是 Krishna 的肤色，比较接近 Krishna 的肤色。
So Ramakali, there's some tamal tree there.
所以 Ramakali 这个地方有一些塔茂树。
And Lord Chaitanya came there, so Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, he put the lotus footprints of Lord Chaitanya there.
主宰太阳马哈帕布来到那个地方，因此就是 Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur。就把这个主宰太阳马哈帕布的莲花足印、哦、就是 安放在那里。
It's a very, very amazing transcendental place.
那里真的是一个非常神奇的超然之地。接下来你们还有问题吗？哦，有现场有人有问题。你的 Guna Prabhu
听说那个第一次要去到文达本的人必须得到这个 Radharani 皇后的这个允许，可不可以请马拉去帮我们讲一下这样子的一个故事，
讲这里这个原因背后的故事吗？
对
关于
就是when we the first time when we go to Vrindavan we need to get a permission of Srimati Radharani, so he would like to know the reason and any story about this.
Well, I never heard you had to get permission from Radharani, but I know when we come to Mayapur you have to get permission from Lord Shiva.
我是没有听说过去 Vrindavan 要得到 Srimati Radharani 的允许，但是我知道到 Mayapur 要得到主 Shiva 的允许。
Lord Shiva is Kshetrapal, we say Kshetrapal Shiva. It means he's the protector of the holy Dham.
因为主 Shiva 他是圣地的保护者。
Kshetrapal.And when we come to Mayapur and when we go out for the around the holy places, first thing we go to see Lord Shiva and we ask Lord Shiva's permission to enter into the holy Dham.
所以我们刚到圣地的时候，像玛雅普圣地，我们会首先去拜见主师吧，去得到他的允许，我们才能够再去参拜这个圣地。
So maybe that Vrindavan, because Vrindavan is the property of Vrindadevi, but Vrindadevi gave it to Radharani, and so Radharani is the proprietor of Vrindavan. So you want to enter Vrindavan, you have to get the mercy of Radharani.
因为整个 Vrindavan 都是Vrindadevi, 哈 Vrindadevi 的就是他所拥有的，那也许是 Vrindadevi 把这个东西，这个拥有的整个 Vrindavan 给了这个权利给了 Srimati Radharani, 献给了他，所以因此进入 Vrindavan 是要得到他的允许，这样。
Come on somebody's property, you have to get their permission.
我们如果来到了某个人的，就是他们所在的地方，对不对？就是他们的土地，他们的财产，我们总是要得到他们的允许啊。
Is there any other question?
Yeah. Annapurna. 我因为用手机，我都看不到完整的名字。
对 ，Annapurna。
对，迪拜古鲁和奉献者，如果弟子的本相 Svarup 在 Dwarka。而灵性导师的 Svarup 在 Goloka Vrindavan， 在这种情况下，学生应该寻找另外一位老师吗？
You don't like to go to Dwarka?
你不喜欢去 Dwarka 吗？
You know, Dwarka is also the spiritual world.
Dwarka 也是在灵性世界。
Do you know what is your spirit?
你知道 你自己的 Svarup 是什么吗？
How do you know your Svarup is not Dwarka?
他说如果弟子的是在 Dwarka， 他说如果就是 Disciples Svarup is in Dwarka and the Spiritual Master Svarup is in Goloka Vrindavan， So in such a situation a student should to look for another teacher？
No, no.
不用，不需要。
不需要。You want to go to God? The spiritual master can arrange for you to go to Dwarka.
灵性导师，会替你做这样的安排。If he want to go to Dwarka?
Yeah. If you think your Swarup is Dwarka.
如果你认为你自己的 Swarup 是 Dwarka， 那么你的灵性导师也会做安排。还有接下来是Kamala Chandra Chandrika Madaju， 我顶礼上师的莲花族，我们怎样才能够取悦我们敬爱的 Guru Maharaj， 我们怎样才能服务他呢？
By chanting Hare Krishna nicely，
好好的念诵 Hare Krishna 就可以取悦灵性导师。
Wherever you go, wherever you meet, tell them about Krishna。
无论你去到哪里，你都向人们讲述 Krishna， 然后好好的阅读学了 Prabhupada 的书。 OK， and then 下一个是谁？ Krishna Das 吗？
他是 K Das。
K Das 顶拜 Guru， 请问 Bhishma Pantra， Bhishma Pantra the 4 days，We all have to follow Ekadasi diet?
No.
Tomorrow, how to break the break? How to break the Ekadasi?
Well, I explained that already.
Maharaj 说他已经解释过了。
If you're following Ekadasi strictly, then you don't eat or drink, and you can break the fast by just drinking water.
如果今天是很严格的遵循，连水都断了，断水，就是。戒水，戒食的话，那么明天就是用喝水来打破这个断食。
But this is not compulsory for everyone.
但是大家要了解，这不是强制性的，不需没有强制性的，没有说一定要遵守。
Yeah. Some people like to do some austerity.
有些人他们是喜欢从事苦行。
So if you like, if you're inclined that way, if you're not busy, you're not working very much,
如果你不是很忙，你的工作的那个担子不是那么重那么费劲的话，你想遵守是可以遵守。
嗯嗯。
然后接下来是安娜普纳，古鲁哈拉吉总是睡得很少，他的力量从何而来？
From Krishna.
来自 Krishna。
Everyone's ability comes from.
所有的力量都是来自 Krishna。走，最后一个 ，Kamala Chandrika Mataji。有人告诉我，住在 Krishna 信徒家中。就是住在奉献者家中的猫和狗也会得到灵性上的发展，这样的猫和狗只吃 Krishna Prasadam 成为素食者，还会听课念 Hare Krishna Mantra 遵守清净的原则，这样的动物真的会对 Krishna 有一些虔诚吗？他们来生会怎么样呢？
Well, they're fortunate souls.
这些猫狗也是很幸运的灵魂。
We'll wish them well in their future journey.
我们祝他们好运啊，他们的未来的这个道路呢，祝他们一切好运。
It may be their last birth before they go back to Godhead.
也许是他们是回归守神的最后一世，也是有可能。
Prabhupada said one time.That he thought maybe there were some pigs there in Vrindavan, and he said that these pigs actually they were, in their previous life they had been yogis, but they had made some offense, and they had to suffer. They had to come in the pig's body.
They made some offense. They made some offense. Offense. Okay, Srila Prabhupada 有一次就讲到在 Vrindavan 看到一些猪，然后 Srila Prabhupada 就说这些呀。猪啊，他们其实已经是他们的最后一世，他们就要回归守神了。他们前世是因为冒犯的，他们是一些瑜伽师，他们冒犯了，所以他们才会投身为猪啊。但是最后一世
，and next they'll go back to God，
然后结束了就会回到就是灵性世界了。
And Bhaktivinoda Thakur said, "Let me take birth even as a dog."Yeah, I don't mind to become a dog, but let it be in the home of a devotee.
那 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 他是这么说的，啊，他说如果只要我能够投身在奉献者的家庭中，哪怕我是投身为一只狗，好，我都高兴，
then I will,
我都愿意，我都愿。
I get the remnants of the Vaishnava.
因为我在奉献者的家中，我虽然是一只狗，我还是可以得到 prasadam， 就是对，可以。得到这些主人给我的 prasada，
and I'll hear the holy name.
我还是可以听得到圣名。好，这先生已经没有问题了哈。
对，
奉献者们还有问题吗？有没有人有问题？苏金姐有问题吗？好像有一点问题哦。没有。
好，Hare Krishna，Shri Prabhupada
Ki Jai。